Hello everyone, this is part 3 of my Civilization 5 playthrough. In part 1 I rolled Korea as my civilization, and in the first two parts I ran through the initial setting up my capital and so on. And I actually got a particularly good opening location. I'm playing on a Pangaea map, and there's only one link to the rest of the continent, which is covered by a city-state. And that means that I am not likely to, in the immediate future, face any particular competition for settling this area. Now, this doesn't happen very often when you're playing Pangaea. Usually it only happens when you're playing with continents or something, where you end up getting a rolling on a reasonably sized island with no neighbors. But at least in this case, I didn't need to get astronomy, is it, that gives embarked units the ability to cross oceans in order to get to the rest of the land. But it also means I didn't meet any other civilizations until I got out onto the rest of the continent. I'm going to actually irrigate my wheat here. But anyway, it means that I didn't meet any other civilizations, so it's a pretty good bet that somebody else is going to end up with the World Congress. That's not as big of a handicap as you might think, though. It also means that I didn't have to compete with other civilizations for all of the ancient ruins in this particular area. So that meant I got something like a dozen of them, and that allowed me to get first pantheon, first religion, and first enhanced religion. And by an amazingly lucky roll, I actually got exactly the tenets for my religion that I wanted. That doesn't happen very often, but it did this time. Now, I should note that I'm playing this on Prince difficulty, which means that, the strategies I'm using here aren't necessarily going to be applicable for a higher level difficulty, and it certainly wouldn't work on Deity. Then again, I am playing the game for fun, which means that I don't really want the insane challenge the Deity provides. So I'm wandering around here, killing off barbarians to pick up some cash, and I'm working on defending my cities here, because I really need to do that, at the very least from the barbarians. But I also want to make sure that I have some sort of military, so that later when I'm meeting other civilizations, they don't feel like I'm an easy, soft target to attack. And you may recall that my archer there started out as a scout. I should clear that encampment there, so that I don't have to keep killing off barbarians there. Okay, good. That's done. Now I'll put my... what am I doing here? Right. Right, so I'll come over here and I'll start improving around my third city there. Now I need to start building science buildings here, like libraries, so that I don't fall behind terribly on science. But I also need to make sure that I keep my cultural stuff going and all of that jazz. Okay, my golden age has ended, so that now I've got a gold deficit. But that's not a big deal right now, since I have cash in the bank, and that's a good reason to run around killing off the barbarians. Because it means that you can run a deficit without actually having it affect your science production. Okay, so I'm going to irrigate the plains tiles. Not much point doing the desert tiles first, because that's just going to bring them up to steady state, as opposed to losing. So, and I should mention that I'm going one tile at a time here with my exploration, so that I can actually look around what's there before going to the next one. Otherwise, I could end up barreling right past a barbarian when, in fact, I could take a pot shot at him first if I had only moved one tile. Okay, so I've got one warrior stationed in each city, so I'm going to build a library in my capital now. Since I didn't get the Great Library, I actually have to build one in the capital. But now I've got some defense going on there. There's another barbarian camp that I can go after. So I'll keep going here. It's nice with the hand axes if you can pick them off with an archer from a whole extra tile away, because then the hand axe has no possible way to attack you, since it only has a range of one. Okay, that's that encampment cleared. Now I could continue working around the coast, and I think that's what I'll do, which means I'll have to go back down this way. I'll probably come down this side of the river. Okay, so that's my wheat irrigated, so however you say that, Jeonju will grow a little faster. I'll farm the tile. Okay, so someone built the Colossus. That's a coastal one, a trade-oriented one. I almost never get the Colossus, so I'm not overly worried about that. I don't have anything else I can do over here, but I'm going to keep the worker over here because that's actually where I'm going to want to start building roads from when I research the wheel. Oh, there's a city-state there. And as expected, we are not the first people to meet them. That's Melbourne. Okay. So I'll put that worker to sleep until it's got something to do. So I'll keep wandering around over here. Eventually I'll get to this encampment that Melbourne's targeting. I'll take that out for the quick influence boost there. And of course, the usual gold and that sort of thing. Okay, now I've got a workboat here, so I'll actually do something with the fish there. What? Oh. Okay, so I'll take out that camp next. Now over here, what do I want to do here? It's recommending a scout, but that's kind of pointless at this point in time. I don't want too many units running around. I'm already running a deficit, so I'm going to keep the number of units down. A granary would allow my city to grow faster, but the lighthouse will make these tiles more useful. And that's going to be a large chunk of my land for this city, so or my tiles. So I really do want the lighthouse on that one. Okay, so I'll go after my barbarian friend there. Somebody finally got around to a pantheon. Well, that's culture from plantations. Okay, so I've got a loose barbarian here. I'll actually go after that. The loose barbarians are easier to kill, and you don't want them marauding around attacking you. So it's good to clear them. And since he obligingly stayed within my range, I'll have him done this turn. Now, I only have one tile left in the range of this city, so I'll put a farm there. There, he's gone, and that one's down, so I should kill this one next turn. Okay, and yep, I did. And I've cleared the encampment. Oh, there's another loose barbarian. So now I'm friends with Melbourne for a while. That's extra happiness. So, ooh, I met Polynesia now. Yeah, he's got a scout in the water. Not surprising that. I'm gonna have to go and start working on barbarians over there at some point. Okay, so that's philosophy. I can now build the oracle. I'm gonna go after that though. Okay, so what next? I really need to catch up on some of these things, but I want to know which technology gets me Petra. Engineering for Great Wall. Petra is currency. Okay. I'm going to aim for currency. No, it's a straight shot over. So it's catching up with archery. And that gets me wheel as well. So that's definitely where I want to go. And in my capital, I actually finished my library. So I'll now start working on the oracle. And while I'm doing that, I'm going to put it on production focus. Does that change anything? Well, it takes two turns off it, so that's probably fine. Okay, yeah, why not? We'll have an embassy. Now I know where his capital is, which is way over there. Okay, so I'll take that guy out. I'm going to get a promotion soon on that archer, but I've got this guy coming here. I'm going to actually go after it. So if I get some of these warriors I've built, I've trained here, gaining some experience, then they'll be much more effective units later on when I upgrade them. Okay. Oh, I've acquired that wheat tile. Okay, I'll attack the hand axe, but I'm gonna have to let this guy heal now. But that's two attacks. It should be enough experience for a promotion. Okay, that's a great engineer. That's actually good. Okay, so I want to farm the wheat. And actually, because the Oracle gives a free social policy, and that's such a useful thing to have, I'm actually going to hurry it. And I have to, well, first of all, I'll promote him. And then I gotta back him off. Okay, so here we go. So I don't want to lose that warrior, so I have to let him heal. There we go. Free social policy. So I'll let the warrior heal. So my policy here, this one gives me a settler, which would be useful. This one gives me a golden age right away. And I think that's probably my better option right now. So I could also open aesthetics. But no, I'm going to... I'm going to go for this one. It's going to cut my cost for social policies, and that's going to pay off pretty quickly in the short term anyway. Now I need to build something here. Circus will increase happiness. I'm not hurting for that in my empire. Walls, I can put those off. Barracks would be useful potentially. But the temple increases my faith production. And it may be surprising to a lot of people, but faith is actually worth a lot in the long term, because later on you can purchase great people with faith, and that's immensely useful later on. That's the equivalent of several free great scientists, great engineers, and so on. Which greatly improves your generation of those things, and it can really catch you up scientifically or culturally. So if you haven't been playing with a faith-based game, it's something that you should consider. And even if you don't manage to get a religion, since there are in fact a limited number of religions available in the game, even if you don't manage to get a religion, faith can still be used to purchase great people, as long as you have the right social policies and so on. And it's something that I didn't realize for a long time until I was watching some playthroughs on YouTube, that faith was actually worth something. And once I discovered that, I started changing my opening strategy so that I actually run for a religion. And also, there's the pagodas and so on, if you get them, which are actually quite useful for improving faith production, but also the rest of your empire. And it's well worth working on those to keep your empire functioning. Oh, somebody finally founded a religion. Now, there'll still be a point here where I'll end up accumulating faith and generating great profits when I don't have any use for them. And in that case, I'll plant them as religious sites, and that will gain me at least potentially some culture and so on. And also faith, which is quite good. Okay, so I've got nothing more to do in around here, but I can improve that one, so I'll do that. Ah, here. More barbarians. I think I probably should open honor. That'll at least show me where all the barbarian camps are in the explored territory as well, which could be useful. Okay, my warrior is healed now, so I'll come up there and deal with that camp. Okay, so that deals with that. Now, there's also a spearman there, which I'll want to deal with at some point. Okay. Right, so I'm going to have a camp here. Yeah, I really should have taken plus one food for camps. Okay, so I'll work on that barbarian camp there. I should be able to take both of those guys out. And what am... Oh, I've finished a temple there. So what can I build here that's going to be actually useful? Well... one of the things that I have been doing lately is I'll set up trade routes from all my cities to my capital, which will be bringing food. Now, that requires granaries in those cities, so it's a little premature on that. Worker would be premature. Circus would be good. It doesn't have a maintenance cost, so... Okay, yeah, I'll go for that. It's certainly not going to harm anything to have the extra happiness. Honor would also give me a combat strength bonus versus barbarians, so it would make clearing those camps easier. Okay, so there's got to be a couple of barbarian camps near here that have been set up for a while with this many loose barbarians. Unless somebody's got a really unhappy empire and barbarians are spawning inside of it. Oh my. I'm going to let that warrior heal. I really need to kill that archer. It's a 50-50 whether this guy's going to attack the scout or my archer. If he attacks. He attacked me. Okay. Well, take that off and I'll take some points off of there. Now this guy's going to heal anyway because of the promotion, so that's kind of good. Okay, what have I built here? A monument. So what do I want here? Again, I'm going to have a lot of coastal here. And these desert tiles aren't going to be terribly useful unless I've managed to get Petra. So I don't have any sea resources there. So I'm going to build the library first. I'm building the library first so that I can actually build the National College relatively soon before I start building a bunch of cities. Okay. Okay, that loose barbarian wandered over here. And that farm is done. So I'll just park that guy. Okay, that guy's killed off. Good. Can I? Okay, that's good. Oh, somebody managed to get their Reformation. I may not get the Reformation beliefs that I want when the time comes, but they're all pretty decent. Worker, nothing to do there. I'll let him sleep. There's the camp. Okay. And... okay. I'll attack that dude. Okay, I should really go after that camp now. I usually park an archer or a ranged unit inside my cities. Since I hadn't researched archery yet, when I was building my warriors, I couldn't do that. The reason I do that is basically it gives me two attacks for each turn if there's a barbarian handy or hanging around. It makes defending the cities easier. And it doesn't apply just to barbarians, obviously. Now, what I really want for a defensive unit is something that upgrades to a rocket artillery. But at this stage in the game, there isn't anything, because that would be the catapult. Archers... I'm going to build an archer here anyway, but archers, they upgrade to composite bowmen, which are still pretty good, and crossbowmen, which are still pretty good because they're range 2, but the Gatling gun is range 1. It's still pretty strong, but it's essentially a melee unit, and that upgrades to a machine gun, which is again range 1, so it's essentially a melee unit. And then that goes up to a bazooka, which is the same. It's essentially a melee unit. So those aren't nearly as useful as they would seem. I'd much rather have rocket artillery, which has a range of 3 and can shoot over obstacles. Anyway, what was that? Oh, right, it's waiting. Okay, that's wheel. I can start building roads. Okay, so I've taken that barbarian out. I'm going to need to fix all of these things too, because now I've lost horses and ivory. And I need to do that before I end up going unhappy here. Well, that's annoying. Got an archer set up there. And what's really annoying is every time the bloody barbarian pillages... ooh, that's nasty. I don't want my settler captured, or my worker captured. Okay. Hopefully next turn I'll be able to kill that bastard. It's getting annoying with the bugger running around there. Yeah, I definitely need to. So, fire. Yeah, I didn't quite kill him. You know, I've got wheels, so I might as well build my start building my road network. Okay, that's good. Oh, there's Polynesia. Okay, so that's why the guy came across on the ocean. I'm up there fairly good with progressive, that's number of social policies. And that's because I had those ruins early on. Okay, now that bugger's gone. Right. Okay, I can start building my road. Now my road's gonna have to go around this way because I can't build it over the mountains. So, I'll start out there building the road. This might be a good spot. These two might be good spots for pontoon bridges. That will shorten the travel time around the coast. I can't just build one across here because the pontoon bridge needs 4 land tiles adjacent to it. So here, I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here, I got 1, 2, 3, 4. So I could theoretically build a road across it. Problem is, building a pontoon bridge consumes a worker. And I want to avoid doing that too often anyway. Okay, so here's an archer. I'm going to look at what I can build here. And yeah, I'm going to expand my army here. So I'm going to put an archer in each city. Okay, so I'll start with building a road there. And work my way around the coast there. Golden Age ended. I can adopt a policy. Honor be useful, but I'm gonna go for that one. Gives me a settler. And that'll get me my 4th city out. And that will be quite useful to have. Let's see, where do I want to build that city? I want it to be somewhere I'm going to have good resources. Okay, I've got a luxury resource here. So, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Well, I probably want to be on the river. So if I build it here, well, that gives me a mountain as well. Gives me, or I can put an observatory. Okay, so from here, that's 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Yeah, that's a good spot. It doesn't crowd anybody. So I'll bring my warrior out here. So I can protect my settler. Okay, I'll keep wandering around the coast here. So there's this great big peninsula thing here. Oh, more barbarians. Okay. Go after them. So as you can see, this can get pretty tedious. I don't use the auto explore capability because it tends to get the units doing the exploration stuck in loops. And it's not particularly efficient the way it does the exploration either. So I just don't do that. Okay, here's the archer. I'll park him there. Okay, now my empire's gone unhappy. And it's going to get worse when I build this city. Oh my. Go after the stronger units first. Okay, and I'll, as usual, start with a shrine. Okay, so I need to get a worker out here. So here's the easy way to do that. Worker. Oh, right. I'm gonna have to move this dude out of there. And there we go. Okay, that's one road tile. This will be a good spot for a pontoon bridge as well. Okay, so I really need to get that one repaired. Okay, kill that, kill that. Hopefully that guy goes back in there. Yep, he did. Okay. Okay, now my gold's gone negative and it's really impacting things, so I could end up with units disbanding on me here. So I really do need to get some gold going here. Okay. He's offering iron for truffles. No, I want gold for them. No. Okay. So I have an archer here. Work on my extending my road there. Hopefully I can clear that right away. Buy me a few turns. Let's see, yeah. Library. Okay, what can I build here that's going to be useful? Well, not over much. Let's see. Yeah, I'll build more archers then. Okay, so a road there. Collect that. That's going to give me 5 turns. That's a big loss per turn. So I really need to do something about the gold. Actually, I might be able to. Okay, that's good. Now, over here. Right, if I put that... right. Anyway, we'll keep on going. I'll just have to play through this. And this is bad. So I do definitely need to do something about that. Fixing this will help, actually. Okay, so that's improved that. Right. Okay. Okay, the Terracotta Army basically gives you a duplicate unit for of each type that you have. Given my current situation, it wouldn't have been terribly useful. Okay, so I've got a road here. And as I said, this would be a perfect spot for a pontoon bridge. Now, I don't think I have the... which one is it? I don't think I have the, technology I need for it. Oh, it's engineering. Okay. Yeah, I don't have the tech for it. So I'll have to go around. Okay. Good. Of course, building roads is costing money as well, so I'm definitely going to need to do something here to improve it. Circus. No science. Ooh, that's bad. Send him down here and deal with that. Yeah, my gold deficit is a significant problem right now. And it's actually the worst I've ever had it when I've been playing a game. I had a city grow. What I really need to do is open up tradition. Is there's a tenet in there, or a policy in there, that really does help with gold usage. Okay, what have I got here? Okay, that's a circus. You know what? I'm just going to expand further. I'm already hurt, and I might as well. Oh, wild. Wonder why there was no barbarian in there. What a horseman. Okay, so the barbarian horseman went away. Worker, right, I need to go over this way. I think I'm gonna want to build a city here. Even if it is going to collide with my capital, I think I will want to. Okay, monument time. Okay, I can buy something with faith here. I should... pagoda. Need to remember to do that before a great prophet spawns. Yeah, I really stepped into a barbarian horde up here. Ooh, city-state. Yeah, come on, update. There's a road here, but it's not showing it. There's got to be an encampment or two up here. Ah, there's one. Oh, it finally updated it. Okay, I need to fix that one. Oop, the Mayans. Maybe they'll offer me gold for something. I think I'm going to have to restart the game for the next part. It's not actually updating things properly here. Warrior, right. Okay, that's a settler, right? And I wanted to build it here. Again, I've got nothing I can build there that's useful. Okay. As I said, I'm just going to do settler spam here. Hanging gardens, that's a good one. Okay, markets will be useful. I'll definitely be wanting to build those. Library. Granary. Yep, I definitely need to be building those. Oh, right. I have to open tradition first. So with that settler, I'm going for improving the wine resource, which should keep my empire from going unhappy on top of massively in debt. Let's see. Okay, so I'm coming up on an hour for this part. So I'm going to play a few more turns out, and then I'll call it a part. Okay, so I can build my city here. Let's see. Ooh, a natural wonder. And barbarians. So I'll build a plantation on the wine. I'll go after that guy. Come on. Right. Yeah, that's. I'm gonna have to wait there till the city-state warrior moves along. Oh, I can buy something with faith. Okay, I'll buy the mosque here. Religion hasn't spread usefully. Okay, so I'm gonna have to start building missionaries, I think. Should I build here? Okay, granary, I think. Okay, that seems reasonable. Huh? Okay, that's a city connection. Oh, I'm probably going to lose that warrior next turn. Which, truth be told, probably wouldn't be a big loss. A barbarian killed. Yes, I was right. That warrior died. And now I need to figure out where to. Well, I'm just going to let that sit for a turn. Okay. Now, what am I building here? I'll build walls there as a. Okay. Okay, so now I can protect my settler. Now I can move it. Oh, there's somebody up here. Yeah, that seems. Yeah, that seems like a good spot. Okay, so I'm going to call it a part here. So I'll save my game. Okay, so that's the end of the third part here on turn 346. It won't be too much longer before things really start to roll along. Hopefully next time around I'll manage to sort out my deficit. I'm certainly causing myself harm on science at this point in time. So I'll definitely have to straighten that out next time. Once I research currency, that'll be a lot easier. But there's a policy, some policies under tradition that also help. So next time, it's getting out of debt. I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.